That is a really lifelike hologram of my daughter, because there is no way my Macy would be up and at him before 10 a.m.
Ha ha. I'm working on my short story application. You proud?
Yes. But I haven't seen you in days. I was starting to get worried.
Well, thanks for checking on me.
I was giving you your privacy. Honey, you're 25. I think it's about time you became independent.
I am independent. Just because I'm living with you doesn't mean I'm not independent. I've been going to the movies and going to dinners by myself since I was 16.
Hating people and being independent, two totally different things. I'm sorry. Your short story, tell me about it.
I don't want to tell you about it. It's bad luck for writers to talk about it before it's been published. You know that I'm superstitious.
Honey, I think it's your fear talking.
Constantly. What day is it?
Monday, the 7th.
Of September?
Yes.
Of 2015?
Of course.
Holy crap! I gotta go pick up this kid and take him to school. I completely forgot. I gotta go.
It's a good thing you have a job, because remember, I'm cutting off your therapy money at the end of the month.
That's to your detriment.
I don't know. Who are you?
I'm Macy. I'm taking you to school. Sorry I'm late.
So, how's youth?
Everything I ever hoped it would be.
Well, good.
All the gentry.
Just holler at me when I need to turn.
You don't know how to get there?
Your mom gave it to me, the address, but I think I left it at home.
My mom sure knows how to pick them.
Should I be turning anytime soon?
Nope.
Is your school on this road?
Nope.
Wait, am I not taking you to school? Oh no, did I apply to be a tutor? I can't be a tutor, Macy can't tutor, Macy can't teach, Macy can pick up, Macy can drop off, that's it.
Good grief, take a Valium. You're not supposed to be my tutor, I just don't want to go to school.
Phew, thank God. Wait, why don't you want to go to school?
I just don't.
Listen, Bradley, I don't want to go to school either, but this is my only job. Okay, and I'm not gonna get fired.
Okay, perfect. Take me to school.
All right.
Fuck, jissicles. I don't know where I'm going. You knew that. What do I have to do to convince you to go?
I have a proposition.
All right.
If you let me skip school, I'll tell my mom you took me there. In fact, I'll tell her that you're the best driver I've ever had. That you're the most loving, nurturing, safe driver. And that she should give you a raise. Wait, you haven't met her yet, right?
No, I've just talked to her on the phone.
Okay, good. She might believe me then. So what do you say?
You better be convincing.
Oh, I will. Okay, so I need you to call the school and tell them that I'm sick.
I am a frequent flyer of the fake sick phone calls. Give me your phone.
Is that it, Mark?
Mm-hmm. Bruin Academy?
Hi. Yes, hello. This is Jane, Bradley's mother.
Hi.
Yes, hi. Yes, I'm sorry, but Bradley's really not feeling well. His head is hotter than a billy goat's ass in a pepper patch. Oh, my. It looked like he just made an offering to the porcelain god. Yes.
Hope he feels better.
I'm sure he'll be better in the morrow.
Bye.
Yeah, cheerio.
Well, that was an interesting rendition of my California Bradmother.
I thought she was British, but I was nervous.
Well, since my ass isn't actually in a Peppa Patch, let's go do something fun.
Okay, what TV show are you feeling?
No. I have a couple other things in mind.
Whatever they are, I don't have the energy for them.
You shiftless slug. Well, get yourself some coffee. Either that, or I'll tell my mom that you wouldn't take me to school.
And people wonder why I hate kids.
What was that?
Nothing. Let's go.
So, Macy.
Why didn't you want to go to school today so badly?
Because the education system is flawed, and I refuse to put up with it for another minute.
Okay, yeah, sure. It's flawed. But that's not why you didn't want to go to school.
You're so presumptuous. Fine. I have a paper I'm supposed to read in front of the class, and reading aloud isn't actually my forte. Shocking, I know.
But you can't just miss school out of fear. You'll never get better if you don't try.
I'm gonna take advice from a 25-year-old who drives kids to school for fear of losing her therapy funds.
Okay, you don't even know what the hell you're talking about.
Oh yeah, then why is this your only job? It's hard for me to think that this was your dream.
You're so presumptuous. I want to be a writer, but that's not easy to come by. There's a short story application. It's a writing contest, and it's due tomorrow. I think I'm going to do that.
You're afraid of trying to write and finding out that you might suck at it.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm afraid of sitting down and not having any good ideas.
Yeah, I get it. But what you just said to me about conquering your fears is applicable to you too. If I can read, you can write.
Okay. Yeah. What time is this paper you have to read to this class?
3.
It's 1:45. We got time. You're reading this paper.
Under one condition.
Of course there's a condition. What is it?
You write your short story tonight.
Okay, you got a deal.
Thanks for playing hooky with me today. Had a great time.
Me too. And good luck on that paper. You got this.
Thanks. Hey. Don't you forget about me.
How could I? I'm picking you up in the morning.